Hello there, folks. This is Flint here. Today we're going to be playing one of the campaigns for the African Kingdoms, which is the latest expansion for Age of Empires 2 HD Edition. Now, as somebody who played Age of Empires 2 around the time when it first came out, so I was around probably 14, 15, and then when the Conquerors came out again, I got that, and it was really fantastic. Love this game. I really can't believe that, like, literally, what, 12 years later, they're coming out with new expansions. I heard this was pretty good, so I'm interested in seeing what they've done with it. I bought both of the new expansions after they came out, but honestly, I haven't played much with it. I don't really know what to expect. I watched some of the preview videos. It looked really cool. So, let's just jump in here. I think we're going to go with Francisco de Almeida. The old world.
My captain is dead. Tell King Manuel that the red blood of Francisco de Almeida, conqueror of the Indies,
wow, they've got voice acting for this.
White beach at the edge of his empire. After braving Spanish knights, Berber, lies they whisper did not.
I think Memorgan's gonna skip this.
Francisco, my father's army is broken, and the Aragonese approach Toro. We must defend the city, Sao Jorge!
Wow, I haven't played one of the campaigns on here in a really long time, so let's see what
Entendido.
We've got pikemen, we've got crossbowmen, we've got Prince Juan, which is like a cavalier, and cannoneers. So objectives, defend the city of Toro, which is, I assume, this thing over here. Okay. Oh yeah, it says Great City of Toro. Oh wow, alright. Let's make sure we focus fire on the infantry. Okay. No. Kinda caught me off guard there. Man.
We cannot hide in Toro like rats. Our enemies have three camps between here and Zamora,
like, really
that we must
that
destroy.
I'm just going to restart and make sure to do that right. That's not a good way to open this campaign.
Francisco, my father's army is broken and the Aragonese approach Toro. We must defend
the
city.
Let's turn down the... Let's turn on the scroll inertia. Wow. Yeah, this game has changed. It's also switched to fast speed.
Entendido.
I don't like how the game does that. Just a second. Scroll inertia. Just none. No. It's like jerky. Why can't it just be the way it was like before? Okay, well. Oh, now this is a lot better. Okay. Now let's kill those infantry. Focus fire on them.
Cannot hide in Toro like rats. Our enemies have three camps between here and Zamora that we must destroy.
That turned out a little better, I think, this time. Alright, okay, so let's check out what we got going on here. So objectives, I said, defend the city of Toro and destroy the three Aragonese military camps. And the Aragonese are those yellow guys. Secondary objectives. Hints. They're restricted to the castle age and a population limit of 100. Aragonese can train new units while you initially cannot, so speed and aggressiveness is critical. Okay, so we don't want to dawdle. We want to try and destroy these camps as soon as possible. Killing the Duke of Alba and Cardinal Mendoza before the camps are destroyed will allow you to begin the build and destroy portion of the city with more resources. Okay. The bridge into Isabeleta held Zamora is well defended, but fighting a beachhead further east will give you access to less defended parts of the city and farmlands. Alright. Commands the Reserve River and Green. Alfonso's army, Red Portuguese, has routed after being defeated by Aragon. The remnants hide on the outskirts of the battlefield. Okay, so I think we're supposed to go around and find, like, the lost bits of this guy's army. And if we bring our Prince Juan character.
A few men, but many soldiers are hiding in the wilderness.
Ah, yeah. See if we bring him over there, then they'll join us.
They will find their courage.
I'm gonna make him just group one, just so he's easy to find. Excellent.
The soldiers report the Duke of Alba and Cardinal Mendoza are patrolling nearby. Capturing them would fetch a large ransom.
Well, we already learned that from the hints, but okay. Now, Portuguese. I haven't played this yet, so let's take a look at the Portuguese for a minute. Naval and gunpowder civilization. All units cost minus 15 gold. 15% gold. Ships plus 10% HP. Can build a Feitoria in the Imperial Age. Alright, what's that? Feitoria. Economic building. Generates resources without the need of villagers. Requires 20 population. Wow, okay. That's interesting. And I see we had some weird kind of archer down there. There. Italians. Oh, that's that. Oh, okay. Now, this is the Italian unit, the Genoese crossbowmen. So they get a bonus attack against cavalry. Alright. Okay. I really gotta get used to that scrolling.
Entendido. Entendido. Entendido.
I gotta say, one thing that I noticed about this new campaign is the scenery looks really nice. Like, you know, if you go back and play some of the older, some of the original campaigns from, like, Age of Kings, like, they don't look terrible, but they're not nearly as ornate as this. Like, look, you got, like, these rocks down here. Got some interesting. Or here we have, like, a little cemetery with, like, birds flying over. Like, there's a lot of really cool effects. Oh, okay. Here's another part of Alfonso's arm. See, it's like a lumber yard here. Like, a real lumber yard. Alright, excellent. Okay. I'm just gonna quick save my game here. Just save Portugal 1, I guess. Okay. Alright.
Scene.
Okay. Well, we're looking around for the parts of this guy's army, I guess. There's a little path that might have something. A canoe. Okay. Oh, a bear. Alright. I guess this expansion has like a bunch of new animals too. Yeah, see, like, look at that. Like, that wall looks really cool with that tower. Oh, that? No, that's not a tower. Oh, I think I saw a little pikeman over there. Ah, okay, here we go. Oh, excellent. Yes, okay, that ram is gonna really help us. Because actually, I played around with this first mission a little bit last night, but I couldn't beat it. I just didn't really put in the amount of effort I needed, so I just ended up getting killed, like, super fast. So let's hope that doesn't happen this time. Oh, whoa, what's this? We have barracks here, it's got a technology. Arson. Infantry do more damage versus buildings. Wow, okay. That's new. Oh. Okay. So we have here a missionary as well. Excellent. I'm just gonna quick grab him and run down there. Okay, we've got a relic, but the missionaries, I don't think, can carry relics unless they change that in the original expansion. You want to make sure they have guys garrisoned in your ram so that you can, so that it moves faster. Oh, I think we have one of the military camps here. Alright. Wow. Okay. Okay, let's just get that ram. You can't. Oh, okay. I was kind of confused because it doesn't change like the little icon or whatever. Oh, weird. Uh-oh. No, I don't want that ram to die. Don't let that ram die. Oh. Usually, like, it used to be that if you could attack something in the old game, like a little sword icon, like your... Oh, no. That's not good. Okay, well, let's just load back. Could have done that a little better. All right. Sorry about that, folks. Probably going to edit that out in post-production, honestly. Up the path here. Man, I used to be really good at this game. I feel embarrassed now. Just how bad I've gotten here. Oh. Also, it turned into the sword icon then. I'm a little confused by some of the changes they've made here. Two-button mouse. You need player colors to allow audio tones. Clamp mouse to window. Right mouse button scrolling. Hotkeys.
Farei lo way.
Alright.
Entendido. Farei lo way. Entendido. Sim. Sim. Entendido. Farei lo way.
Oh. Okay, I guess they're not even gonna wait for me. He's gonna. Oh. Excellent. Farei lo way.
Sim.
Okay. And let's bring, Prince Juan or whatever over there. Check this out. Yeah, see, we have like a little like gold mine here. They've added some new art assets. And look at this. We've got the sheep with infinite health. See, like those like little tricks where like you make an unkillable unit or whatever by like infinitely healing its health for like, you know, damaging it for negative HP or whatever. That's a trick that they used in the scenario editor. And that was not in the original campaigns. I think people figured that out making custom campaigns of their own. So, see, we've got like a vineyard. I mean, I don't really know a lot about the team that made the new expansions, but I think it, I'm pretty sure the Forgotten started out as some kind of like fan, just like a cut, like a mod somebody made, right? I might be wrong about that. Okay. What are those guys doing there? Let's see if I can't convert one of these guys. Oh, I guess not. Oh, and I just captured the Duke of Alba. I wasn't even looking. Okay. Well, okay, here's a good time to sort out my units. Okay, so I'm gonna take my cavalry all together, and they're gonna be group one, so it's gonna be like my main body. I got my pikemen, so it's gonna be group two. We're gonna have two different groups of ranged units because I figure I can be focus firing and taking out like individual guys at a time, and then finally just the monks are just gonna be group five. It can be like, okay, excellent.
Avança, entendido.
Okay.
Entendido.
Where did that ram go? I don't remember where that was. I feel dumb now.
Farei lo way.
Oh. Okay. I mean, it's just like a random monk going by, I guess. Yeah, see, this is really interesting. Yeah, so you can see, like, to make this effect where the villager is just, like, continue bashing the sheep. I guess he's, like, shearing it, maybe? They just keep damaging the sheep in the editor, but instead of damaging it for positive damage, they damage it for negative damage. So you see the health bar, like, jumps over to the mini-map. Not a very elegant solution, but it worked. See, there's the camp. So. Also, here this guy... Oh, there's like a little campfire here next to this guy's hut. Wow, okay. Yeah, see, there's a lot of little, like, art enhancements that are in this game that you didn't see, like, in the original versions. Where did that ram go? I don't remember where that is. Okay. Alright, just a sec. I'm gonna save again. Just say Portugal 1. I'm gonna have to relearn the hotkeys. I haven't played this game in so long. Okay. Where's the ram? Like up there? I'm supposed to be somewhere around here. Wow, so this Prince Wand has 390 HP. Like most of those fixed forest scenarios, you want to be like super careful at preserving yourself with, you know, making sure you heal your units, don't let people die unnecessarily. Stand ground. Okay, yeah, so they'll just kind of plink away at him. Oh, that's not good. He's getting chased now by these guys. Move that Genie's crossbow away. Yeah, see, this is like, they're not gonna be able to assault that really effectively. Oh, okay, we have some cavalry now? What I was looking for, but okay, it's a good scouting. Actually, I guess. Okay, that's the second camp. So we got one camp up here and another camp down there. Okay. Oh, okay. Oh, let's just take these guys out then. I'm inside. All right. Are still, our main force is still sitting pretty back there in that little clearing. Not really moving quite as fast now that we got those crossbowmen. Junie's crossbowmen. I haven't played competitively online in a really long time. It makes me wonder, what is this? Is this like a guy you can click on? No, it's like a scarecrow in a farm. Okay, wow. A little hedgerow around it, a bush surrounding the farm. I can tell, like, the art direction here is way better than the original scenario. Like, the original scenarios are, like, maybe we might play those later, but if you could just compare them visually, you know, they're a little sparse, you know? They're kind of bare bones. Oh, okay, we got more cavalry. Right. Back up here by these rocks. Oh, you know what? I think I remember now. That stupid ram is like just right in the corner next to the city. Okay, we'll scout out these areas too. These guys stand ground. Ugh, yeah. Okay, excellent. Okay, well let's get over here. Finally. As soon as he makes it back with the ram, I feel like an idiot. Yeah, this is what I'm like after I've had my coffee. Trying to imagine if I tried to play this without having my coffee. Yeah, if I'm one of those people. Oh, we've got a real force here. Okay, we're gonna have to, like, redo our groups, because... Okay. So... Cavalry up here, and we have this, like, one lancer. Don't exactly remember what that does. We got another lancer. Okay. That's gonna be... Got it. Alright, that's gonna be group one. It's like our main force. Alright. We got a pikeman. That's gonna be group two, so we're gonna use those to protect us from any flanks. Okay, we got our range units. Let's do again. Let's group them up into two different. Be sniping guys. 3, 4. Okay. And then monks are going to be 5, and the ram is just 6. Okay. Alrighty. find it on horse. The Duke of Alba and Carlo Mendoza. Wow, okay. Alright, well, let's do this then.
Indeed, far away.
Alrighty. Let's change the formation right there. Let's get our ranged guys over there and take care of that. Okay, cavalry, Let's get the cavalry in there, yeah, alrighty. And then bring the pikemen up front. Oh, aggressive guys, let's go, let's go. Yeah, we wanna move up, move up. Oh, okay, yeah, we've overrun the camp here. Our monks are still here. Let's have the monks prepare, heal everybody. Okay, let's blow up that watchtower. Everyone an aggressive stance. Oh, actually, you know what? Okay, our ranger's gonna be defensive because we don't want them wandering around following like one random straggler. Got some nice new fire effects.
Only two camps remain. Fight for Portugal and Castile.
Okay. Wow, alrighty. Got like a little trickle of units. I didn't entirely turn the music off, so you might be able to hear it in the background. I really like the soundtrack for Age of Empires. The Conqueror's soundtrack wasn't quite as good, but it's still quite nice. But I really love the classic Age of Empires 2 soundtrack. I don't know if they made any new tracks for the expansions. I should check that. Okay, well, I guess we finished off the first camp. Just gonna quick save. Go. Wow, looking at that, I don't think we took too many casualties there. We lost like one archer. Did we even lose any cavalry at all? I think so. Playing this on standard difficulty, by the way, so yeah, so it's not like I'm some kind of master just, you know, thrashing the AI time and again. AI's a little more solid than I remember. Sure, am I just worse at the game or probably done a few upgrades version. That ram is kind of damaged. If we had like a villager, I could repair it, but I don't think we'd get villagers until later, so I'm just gonna have to deal with it. Alright, so we know that the next camp is up here. Oh, that's a palisade gate. Wow, they gave the palisades gates. That's nice. It's way better than like leaving. I remember like online you'd have to just like leave a little gap and like plug it up with a house or something. It's really nice that they decided to finally let you have a gate for your palisade. Okay, yeah, this is what we wanted. We wanted these guys to come out here. Oh, yeah, excellent. Just let us pick them off one by one instead of making us make a fight at the gate. Excellent, excellent. So, who's going to be defensive except for Captain? Okay. Oh, let's kill those monks. Come on. Get them. Okay, I don't think I lost anybody. Excellent, excellent. Okay. Oh, we just took out Cardinal Mendoza. Excellent. Alright, let's get everyone inside. In case there's some kind of counterattack, we don't want anyone to get caught out. Attack me up here. Oh, the villagers! Oh, the villagers just killed my lancer! Wow. Yeah, that is definitely new. Oh, you know what? Let's see if we can't... Hold on. Because the Spanish get, supremacy? No, I guess. Oh, they are Spanish. Oh, no wonder. those of you playing along at home, one of the Spanish unique texts is supremacy, where they're basically makes their villagers way tougher. So I guess that's why they were able to take out my lancer. Jesus. Okay. Well, we blunted that counterattack up there. Down there, I should say. So, pikeman defensive. This guy's defensive. Yes, press. Oh, and they just managed to.
Aragon is almost defeated. Only one camp remains.
Oh, excellent. Okay. Let's bring the. It looks like the ram didn't take any damage this time. That's good. Let's let the monks heal everybody up. Some spiritual guidance, maybe. And we're just gonna quick save here. Alright. Okay, I don't think we took that many casualties. Well, aside from that lancer, I guess, who got mobbed by villagers. That was not entire. That was a little bit unexpected. I mean, that's not something you see the AI do very often, I remember. Usually, if you can attack them, like, in a group, the villagers would just kind of... They'd stop working and then just kind of sort of disperse and try and go back to work, and then you'd hit them again, and they would just try and leave. Correcto. Wow, the AI is definitely way sharper than what it is. Okay. Just kind of... moving along here. I don't know where this third camp is, but I think we're probably going to find it relatively soon. Oh, and I guess we're allied with these guys. Oh, now that castle looks cool. Oh! Oh, I just spotted some, Eh? Who's attacking me over here? Nobody? Okay. Weird. Oh, I see. Oh, I think that might be where the third camp is, but I spotted some of those red army guys in this like little town. Whoa. I don't want that. Okay, cavalry, he'll take that now. Oh god, I hate those things. Okay. I don't think anybody died. Okay, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna let the monks heal these guys. And Prince Juan is just going to go grab those army guys inside of the town. Those onager, like those catapult things the onagers at. Really hate how the AI uses them. Oh, what? Can I not get by there? Oh, that's a little disappointing. Well, might as well check out this place. Oh, excellent, okay. Well, I didn't expect that, but I'll take it. Oh, kill that scout. Oh, our guys don't have thumb rings, so their accuracy is crap. Okay. Oh, excellent. All right. Get back up here. Okay, and these guys, I guess I'm just going to make them group 7. So they'll be able to snipe, specifically they'll be sniping cavalry if we happen to see any. But I think that this game is, like, the AI isn't really cheating or anything. They're just producing units in these camps. And so we're just going to get, like, this little trickle from now on. It's not going to be, like, oh, okay, that little scout guy if he wants to go. Okay. Okay. Oh, let's bring everyone up into a close formation. No, actually, since we got that onager in there, maybe we shouldn't do that. Entendido. Okay. You know what? Let's take those guys out. Okay, bring the pikemen in. Oh, let's see if we can snipe that cavalry. Yes. Okay, excellent. Oh, and those villagers are running too. Excellent. Okay. Oh man. This try and preserve some guys here. Oh, okay, yeah, I think we're about to overrun this as well. We're still producing units here too, so. Let's get out of here. I don't want my units to get mobbed like last time. Guys, don't. No, just leave the villagers alone for now. What are you doing? No! I told him not to do that. What? They're coming after my ram. Wow, okay. I guess I could try and convert one of these villagers, but I bet that AI just has heresy that can let you do that.
You have achieved a great victory over Aragorn, but do not rest, men. The treacherous followers of Isabella still divide Zamora.
Okay. Well, I haven't actually destroyed this workshop, but okay. Huh? All right. Oh, okay. Very nice. Okay.
See.
There's like no little. Oh, okay. Alright. A little confused because sometimes there's. Oh, okay. The little sound that you get when you click on those guys wasn't playing, so. Okay. Well, I think we've eliminated these guys, so how can I get in here? Can I bring my army inside the walls at all? Ah! Excellent. Okay. Oh, we're getting attacked already. Wow, they're not wasting any time. Eh? Oh man. Heavy pikeman? What is that? Okay, I'm gonna have to check this pikeman halberd here. Oh. Okay. What's a heavy pikeman? I don't want that guy to get killed. I wanna like check out like what can you do? Oh okay, we already have an army in here as well, so. Excellent. Okay, well, we'll just bring them inside here. We don't need to bring the rams out, so just gonna. I don't want. See, I'm really getting slow. I have a Condottiero. Exactly are those? Blowing up my watchtower. What? Oh my god, there's a lot of guys in here. Okay. Alright. We need to move a little faster. Okay, let's garrison inside the watchtower. Alright, looks like my army arrived a little belatedly, but. Okay. Let's get my monks over. Siege tower. Yeah, see this. I guess this is another new unit in the game. What does the siege tower do? Let's see, folks. Siege weapon used to scale enemy walls, resistant to archer attack. Infantry and villagers can garrison inside for transportation. Scale walls. So it's like a battering ram. But can you? Does that mean you can go over the walls with your siege tower? I'm confused. Okay. Well, I'm confused, and you're probably going to hear me say that a lot of times. A bunch of times. Okay. Alright. You know, we should just get some. Oh, okay. I guess we don't have any food. Maybe. We don't have any food. Are we supposed to be like. Okay, well, let's maybe build some farms, I guess. Oh, what are you doing down there? Just go get yourself killed. Okay. I guess that preacher guy got killed at some point, because he's not in my, like, group 5 anymore. Okay, well, I got two monks instead, so that's okay. construir. I'm gonna build some more farms because we got like a bunch of gold but no food. That's not very useful. Okay, so this is our new monk, level 5. See if we can research any texts here. For enemy monks, convert most buildings, fluctuate monk hit points. Yeah, let's go with fervor. Make him move faster. I think that's the slowest unit. We definitely want Bodkin Arrow. We're pretty archer heavy right here, so. Regular pikeman has 55 hit points and 5 attack, and the heavy pikeman has 75 hit points. And otherwise, everything else is the same. Well, that's not so bad, I guess. Let's garrison these rams. Faster. Okay, can we get Bodkin in there? Villager. See these guys at all. Oh, no wood. Cortar madeira. Cortar madeira. Not a problem you won't have, that's for sure. Anyway, okay, I guess we're gonna have to start chopping some wood and okay, excellent. So Bodkin Arrow is on the way, so I'm gonna just have this villager repair this quick have this villager repair that ram. Those rams are expensive. Excellent. Oh, okay. I guess we have like some ships here too. I don't know what we're supposed to do with that. Oh, okay. Let's look back at the. Choose one of the following objectives: destroy the Ibalista's military buildings or the mills. Okay. Finding a beachhead further east will give you access to less defended parts of the city and farmlands. Okay. Scouts. The city of Zamora straddles the Duero west of Toro. The city is divided between the friendly Juanistas, purple Spanish, who control the Nuevamec, and the old Romanesque cathedral and enemy Isabelistas, who command the Peñas de Santa Marta. Rocky outcrop with contatory crossbowmen situated with limited light cavalry. That sounds like it should be pretty easy to defeat, just because we've got a pretty archer heavy here, so. Oh, I see here. Okay. You want the rams. Rams will go first, then. Rams will go first. Yeah, see, so those rams will just soak up all the archer fire. At least I hope. Oh, first casualty. Okay, let's just start blowing stuff up here. Let's just be systematic. Actually, let's bring the rams over and destroy the military buildings. That was one of our objectives. We said pick one, so does that mean that if we succeed in that, the mission is over? Or we just don't want them producing any more units. Oh, okay, that villager kinda got stuck. Oh, okay. Be fishing, and then. And our rams are still looking good. Oh, no. What? Where did that come from? Oh, there's like a little Maganel down there. Ugh, okay. Well, let's just move over here then. See some units down there. I'm just gonna kind of preemptively shoot them. Oh, yeah, because they're stuck on the other side. Oh, this is a good opportunity right here. Don't you want to destroy the... Oh, okay, you can't destroy, like, any of those, like, buildings. Like, the cathedrals. Which makes sense. I don't think that's really what you want to be doing. That's not right. Okay, yeah, those archers are dead. Oh, no. Okay. What's left of my cavalry here? I'll take out that thing. Well, that Maganel's gone finally, so I can go destroy the old castle, is what that building is called. That's actually really cool. We still have... Oh, our monks are still here, and we can still heal everybody, so... Alright, well, I think it's just a matter of time now, so stand ground. Yeah, that's N for stand ground, so I'm starting to get the hang of these hotkeys again. And let's just do a few more. Let's have them on board. It's not really a good wood patch right here, but we want to build knights, I guess. Knights are always good.
Farei lo way. Sim, entendido.
Oh, we don't have a mill. Okay, yeah, for all you youngsters out there who probably maybe never played like the original game without any of the expansions, the single biggest improvement to Age of Empires that came from the Conqueror's expansion was the ability to queue up your farms at the mill. I can't tell you how big this was. That just blew my mind. It wasn't even advertised on the box or anything. I bought it because of the, because it had like the Aztecs and the, you know, the Spanish and some new campaigns, and that sounded really cool. And it was a good expansion. But oh my god, you know, the ability to just I queued up too many. And you
queued.
But the ability to just queue up your farms is huge. I can't tell you how big that is. Like, it used to be that you'd be playing the game, especially late game, where you've just got a massive number of farms, and they would just end up lying fallow. You know, if you got into a battle that lasted for more than a minute, you know, and you couldn't really tear yourself away to spend 5 minutes, you know, reseeding individually every single farm. That was a big, big help. Okay, we're back. Now, those of you playing along at home who may have wondered what was with that weird break and why does my army now look different? For some reason, the game crashed on me. I really don't know why. Anyway, so we're just continuing on. Now, speaking of crashes, I don't know how many of my viewers, if I even have any. I don't know how old you guys are, but I remember playing this game like on the mid-2000s on the MSN Gaming Zone, playing on like the old version of the game, even before they came out with the Conqueror's expansion, let alone all these fancy, you know, updated graphics and all that. And I gotta tell you is that I remember that getting this game to connect over any type of network was a real nightmare. It was a disaster every time, you know? It was slow, it was laggy, the game just didn't want to work, didn't want to connect. I used to play LAN games with some of my dad's friends from work, you know, a lot of engineer guys. And it would always take at least 45 minutes to get everyone's computer to connect to the game. You know, just without fail. We'd have 8 guys there and 7 people would be able to join the game, and this 8th guy would have some kind of problem, and we'd have to be reconfiguring the router and, like, opening ports and... Like, so, I mean, compared to that, playing this game on Steam is just so incredibly easy. It's fantastic. Okay, so. Alright. We want to destroy these military buildings as soon as we can. They're still producing units and, like, just kind of harassing us. I don't know if there's, like, any more... if there's any parts left to this scenario or not. So if we want to be preserving guys for some big fight later, or what? So this looks kind of like, are these like the farmlands that they talked about in the like scenario description? Kind of looks like it. kind of hope we're getting done soon, honestly. There's a whole other part of this map here. Okay, so I think I have an idea. I think maybe the idea was is that you could like build like transport ships and sail like down this like river.
Oh,
I think we may have a winner here. Is that the end? Oh, excellent. Well, I guess that's a wrap, folks.